Folks, my name is Jason. Welcome to Silly Song Sing Along Sunday. How are you doing today? Unfortunately, the sun is not out today. It's a little overcast. As much as my mood. No, not really. I've come to grips with what is what is, and I shall deal with it accordingly. Anyways, so it's rolling along. How was your Valentine weekend? Now, for those of most of you know, I do not celebrate it, nor do I endorse it. And as such, I am very condescending about it. And apparently I've made a few enemies over that, but it is what it is. As such, I do have a question to pose to you. Because this is a real-life situation, and something similar to what I experienced, I actually lost a girlfriend over the fact that I do not celebrate Christmas. Or, I don't get excited about it, I should have said, you know, I don't mind exchanging gifts, stuff like, you know, decorating, I can live with or without it, I guess you could say. That being said, an acquaintance of mine, well, two acquaintances of mine, they've been dating about 4 or 5 months. And I want to say this in the first place, that they are still in high school. And she is contemplating leaving him, dumping him, because he did not do anything for her for Valentine's Day. Now, mind you, the kid is active in sports. He does have a part-time job, although, you know, it's only a few hours a week. But even as such, that is the situation, she thinks she deserves something more. What is your thought on that? Now, I just wanted to, this is going to be the last time I address anything about Valentine's Day for this year, because I hate to rehash with broken records and rolling around in horse crap. So, anyways, on with today's segment. Now, this particular song I have picked out for today, no one requested it. However, I am singing this one in honor of my father, because growing up, I grew up on 33 records, 45 records. You're going, what's 33 records or 45? Those are the speed at which they have to, revolutions per minute they have to make in order for the record to sound proper. There was also 78, and I know there's other ones I'm missing. But anyways, so there were some particular ones that I was very fond of growing up. One was Professor Schnitzel of Turkey Hollow, and he was a Pennsylvania Dutchman, not to be confused with the Amish. So do keep that in mind if you ever do research that. And he was quite the storyteller. You can kind of tell where I get some of that from. And then there was some military record, forget what it was. And I grew up on Elvis gospel records. That's how I knew them. So different things like that. And then there were two gentlemen. And come to think of it, there was the Smothers Brothers too. My dad had one or two of their records. But these other two gentlemen. Oh, and one more. The Bickersons. If you ever get a chance, go to YouTube and type in the Bickersons. They will have you howling. Because this is all like radio. It's like how entertainment used to be on the radio. And this, I don't know if they were actually a husband and wife, I never really fully researched it, but these two, it was something to behold when the husband mistakes wallpaper paste for oatmeal and different things like that. Quite the interesting situations. So, but I know I keep delaying. You're wondering who in the world I want to talk about. Well, I am talking none other than Homer and Jethro. Now you say, who in the world are Homer and Jethro? Well, Homer and Jethro, I'm not sure how long they were together as far as a musical duet, an entertainment duet. And they make for quite the comical things going on around here. And I'll get along with that because this little girl beside me is scaring the snot out of me a little bit. She's sitting there texting and driving while I'm talking to you. Anyways, here we go. This is called The Yellow Rose of Texas. Well, oh, come on now. Be nice to me. How you doing? There we go. Sorry, I gotta let this thing up or start up. Okay, here we go. Ah, just what I want. Here we go. Yellar roads to Texas. Or maybe not. Why does this not want to work for me? Okay. There we go.
Of this earth. Her right eye looks at Dallas, her left one at Fort Worth. Her ponytail's a dandy, that hairdo is a prize. But it comes in handy when she's switching flies. Her skin is red and fuzzy, it feels just like a peach. I looked her over from head to toe, and she got one of each. Her face has fallen arches, it hangs just like a sack. She'd like to have it lifted, but she doesn't have a jack.
Here we go.
Looks just like a weed. That one big upper tooth of hers looks like a pumpkin seed. And when she opens up her mouth, it looks just like a rake. Her lips are just like pebbles, I mean pebbles on a parade. I was standing in the garden when I discovered her. I reached for an old tomato, and darling, there you were. You can take your nice nasturtiums and take your violets blue. And while you're at it, take the Yellar Rose Rexes too. Yo-lay-o, lay-o, yo-lay.
Hey, sir! Hey, wait for me! Wait!
It's getting a little windy out there. Getting pushed all over the road here. Sorry about that. Well, there you have. Oh, they really get pushed all over now. There you have the Yellar Roads of Texas by Homer and Jethro. A special dedication to my dad and my tribute to Valentine's Day because you know how I feel about it. Anyways, y'all have a good week. God bless. I'll see you Tuesday.